Hello everyone, welcome to another devlog of my game Ready Steady Ship. Trust me, for the past week I've been working a lot on my game and finally got something to show you. Before we proceed with the devlog, could you please wishlist the game on Steam? Thank you.
Okay, let's go.
Get it? That was my impression of a well-known meme. Right, so what's new? In the last video, I said I was working on the storyline and cinematics. I showed a little sneak peek and that was it. Well, in this video, I'll show you the process of how I made a couple of cinematics with Unity timeline. What is the Unity timeline? 1 week back, I didn't know it either. Well, turns out that the Unity has a very powerful tool to work with the cinematics and cutscenes. You can simply add it in the Package Manager field. So, how does it work? Basically, something like an animator, except you can add more different objects to one or multiple sequences. Since it's not a tutorial and I still have a lot to show, I'll leave a link to a decent explanation and tutorial on how to use one. So, I wrote a scenario describing all the environments and dialogues. I'm gonna show you a bit of the mechanics office. As I wrote in the scenario, the player should be stacking boxes, and as he does it, the mechanic should call him from behind. Okay, we will start with the boxes stacking part. So I prepared some background. Brick walls and stacks of boxes. I've also added the forklift on the right to reach up the environment a bit. Right, so I'm making the animations of the player stacking boxes. It may not look hard, but I was struggling there a lot. There were a lot of problems with the animation transitions, but somehow I did it. So I made it to the part where the mechanic approaches the player. I couldn't finish the whole scene since I don't have a voiceover of the mechanic yet. Okay, now that's halfway done, we can move to the office part. Oh, I don't have one yet. Let's model it in Blender. So I'm making the mechanic's office, but it's not actually the mechanic's office. I believe this office looks familiar to you. If you think you know whose office this is, leave your answer in the comments. Also, the plant. I was always struggling with the vegetation, but somehow this one turned out kind of okay. How I made it? It's simple. I made some spheres, joined them together and added the particle modifier. And on that particle modifier, I made it to render the plane and added the leaf texture. That's it. Okay, exporting the office model to Unity. I'm kinda happy with the result of how the office turned out. Hopefully when I'll bake this, it will even look better. Very nice. I left it to bake and went out for a coffee. When I got back, I was kind of surprised at how good it looked. I hope you like it as well. Once the environment is done, we can move on with the animations. As I wrote in the scenario, the player should come into the mechanic's office through the door. Okay, now that's done, we can move on with the mechanic. I thought that it should look good that as soon as the player enters the office, the mechanics wave at him as referring to hello. Okay, and done. I sent this short cutscene to my friend and he quickly replied. What, you don't know the basic 180 degree rule of dialogue? And I said, of course I know. Okay, let's rework this one. So the rule is actually pretty simple. Here it is. As soon as I replaced the camera angles, it looked even better. Here's the final result of this shot. Okay, I also cannot do anything more this time since the mechanic voiceover is not done. However, I actually made another cutscene, the very first one. So basically the player is watching the TV in his living room, scrolling through the channels, and he suddenly stops at the news channel. The news basically says that the world lost its mind, people are too lazy, and shipping companies are looking for employees since people are ordering everything online. The player grabs his phone and quickly calls the shipping company for the position. Right. So I already have a living room model, now only what's left is to make the actual animations. Okay, so I made the phone dial image and started working on the new stage. The reporter is one of the player skin. I thought it fits nicely. I also added the news background. I made the breaking news headline in Photoshop and imported it into Unity. Now the lip sync. Actually, this part wasn't as hard as I thought it would be. what about the news reporter sound? Ah, this is fun. I tried the AI tool to record the voice. The result was kind of okay, but I decided to order the voiceover on Fiverr. And actually, I was surprised at how good the voiceover was. Don't worry, you'll get to hear it in a couple of moments. The mouth is basically a sprite. I just scale it and that's it. The most difficult part was figuring out what the player watches on the TV before he turns on the news. I didn't want to show any video, so I made a couple of images and made a slideshow. I also recorded myself mumbling something and added some music. And here is the final result.
Breaking news! The world is under severe threat. Mankind is too lazy to even go outside. People who are staying at home already running out of supplies. The whole world is in trouble, but hopefully you can help. Have you got a working brain? Can you lift a box with your bare hands? And you don't even fear going outside? Then you can save the world. Join the world's best shipping company now.
Ah, this was exhausting. I spent almost the whole day on this. Of course, it could look much better, but for now, I think it's a pretty good result. What do you think? How could I improve it? Leave your thoughts in the comments. Thank you for watching, and till the next one. Bye!